Clearing the decks for 1993 blast convicts hanging, a three-judge bench of Supreme Court rejected Yaqub's mercy petition. Yaqub Memon is slated to be executed at 7 a.m., sending Yaqub to the gallows. The Supreme Court said there was no error in death warrant issued to Yaqub Memon. Defense lawyer had earlier moved the Supreme Court seeking a stay on his execution.
Anand, are you happy with the disposal of this matter?
I am very disappointed and unhappy because I think the Supreme Court has made a tragic mistake in giving and rendering this judgment by truncating a right of a condemned prisoner not to challenge the mercy.
Anand,
earlier petition was filed by his brother. He is entitled under the rules to file a fresh petition to the president, which he did, that is recognized in the rules, that is recognized in the judgment. It is unfortunate that the Supreme Court today and yesterday held that the earlier petition binds him. In my opinion, it is incorrect.
इनका केवल ग्राउंड ये था कि मर्सी पिटीशन रिजेक्ट होने के बाद 14 दिन की रिक्वायरमेंट शत्रुघ्न चौहान का जजमेंट है 2014 का, उसमें कहा गया कि 14 दिन के बाद एग्जीक्यूट होना चाहिए और 14 दिन के पीरियड में उसको एक चैलेंज कर सकता है मर्सी पिटीशन, या फिर उसको कूलिंग ऑफ पीरियड है, या फिर वो विल भी प्रिपेयर कर सकता है। ये तीन कारण उसमें दिए थे, मगर कोर्ट ने कहा कि 2013 में ही पिटीशन जो है मर्सी पिटीशन रिजेक्ट हो गया था,
तो
और 2013 में जो पिटीशन उन्होंने कहा कि उनके भाई के उन्होंने कहा, लेकिन उसको ओन किया था उसने, और उसके बाद अपने तरफ से मर्सी पिटीशन फाइल नहीं किया। ही केप्ट ऑन फाइलिंग अगेन एंड अगेन पिटीशन, सो आफ्टरवर्ड्स फाइनली अब जब ये सारा सब रिजेक्ट हो गया, उसके बाद इस तरह कोर्ट के आना, इट्स विल बी अ ट्रेवेस्टी ऑफ जस्टिस अगर हम इसको स्टे करेंगे। इसलिए इस मामले में जहां पे इतना बड़ा अटैक हुआ था, इतनी लोग जिंदगियां गई थी, इसमें हम स्टे नहीं देते, ना कोई रिजेक्शन डिसमिस कर दिया।
Now, a tight cover of security has been placed at Nagpur jail, which just asked to go for the slated execution. The process of Yaqub's execution has begun inside Nagpur jail. The 1993 blast convict has been given new clothes to wear. It will take another half an hour for the authorities to complete the process. Nagpur jail administration has asked all its staff to deposit mobiles and gadgets ahead of scheduled execution. Even the security has been beefed up in Mumbai with teams deployed near Yaqub's house.
After Supreme Court rejected the final mercy plea of Yaqub Memon, now you can see here in Nagpur that authorities are in full swing and they are preparing for his execution. You can see the police over here on the road which leads to the Nagpur Central Jail. Since yesterday, 144 has been imposed by the authorities over here, and you can see the amount of police over here is really precedented, because we have been given to understand that the more than 20,000 police personnel are here in the city, and they are patrolling since last night. We have seen also that they were checking each and every car, the car papers, the license, and they are taking down the numbers also. But now the authorities are preparing, they are doing their preparation, and it's in full swing after Supreme Court rejected the mercy plea. It was the final mercy plea of Yaqub Memon. We have been given to understand that between 6:30 to 7 a.m. in the morning, the execution will take place in the central jail of Nagpur. In Nagpur, with camera person Samir Shanbagh, Mayuresh Ganpate for India Today.
All right, let's now go across to Anusha Soni, who joins us from outside the Supreme Court, as well as Sahil Joshi, who joins us from outside Yaqub Memon's residence in Mumbai. Let me come across to you, Anusha, first. And we also have India Today's managing editor, Vinay Tiwari, in the studio with us. Anusha, coming across to you first. It's an unprecedented scene that we have seen, that at 2:30 a.m., the Supreme Court actually hears a petition. Just take us through, take our viewers who've just joined in, what exactly happened in the Supreme Court 2:30 a.m. onwards.
Well, just to begin a little bit from earlier, if you remember yesterday at 4:30 p.m. when the judgment came, in which Justice Deepak Mishra rejected both the petitions of Yaqub Memon, it seemed like that as far as the courts of this country are concerned, all the doors for Yaqub Memon are closed. However, at around 10 p.m., there were reports, and the sources were telling us that top lawyers, including Prashant Bhushan, Indra Jaisingh, and many other key lawyers, have reached the residence of the Chief Justice of India. And after the dismissal of the mercy petition of Yaqub Memon by the president, all of these lawyers have been going to the residence to make sure that his death sentence is not executed today. He is given another 14 days to live by, under the guidelines laid down by the Supreme Court in the Shatrughan Chauhan judgment. Around 2 a.m. in the morning, we got to know that the hearing will not take place at the Chief Justice of India's residence or at Justice Deepak Mishra's residence. Our teams were tracking both these locations, but actually at the Supreme Court. At around 2 a.m. in the morning, most of the journalists were rushed at this, Supreme Court, including the top lawyers. The security staff of the Supreme Court was completely taken aback, looking at, such a huge number of people coming to the Supreme Court. But at around 3 a.m. in the morning, finally, when the Attorney General reached the court, that's when the three-judge bench, which had earlier dismissed this petition, started the hearing. The argument started on the earlier lines, on the earlier said lines, but this time the thrust of the argument, which was presented by Anand Grover in this case, was the fact that the judgment in Shatrughan Chauhan gave a convict certain rights and remedies, and he has all the constitutional power to avail to them. This kind of hasty process cannot come in the way. However, it was the argument of Attorney General Mukul Rohatgi which actually found way with the court. Two key points he mentioned. First, he said that there cannot be a principle of ad infinitum. You cannot go on filing mercy petitions. You cannot continue to derail the process of law. By doing this, you are procrastinating this entire procedure. Taking this argument into account, Justice Deepak Mishra, when he pronounced his judgment, he said it would be a travesty of justice if this person is given any more time. The Supreme Court of this country has given him enough time, enough chances to present his case.
That's right, Anusha. Thanks very much for bringing us up to speed what happened overnight. Vinay, what happened last night in the Supreme Court, this morning, in the wee hours, in fact, is unprecedented. I mean, is there a precedence of this kind in the past as far as the Supreme Court is concerned? Also, this point, last point that Anusha was mentioning about filing mercy pleas again and again and again. And the Supreme Court eventually is saying that this almost amounts to procrastination. Is there a precedence of this kind also, where once it has been rejected, you file another mercy plea on certain other grounds?
Well, to answer the first question, Sanket, yes, there have been precedences of hearings happening in the middle of the night. Mm-hmm. But the difference is that those hearings have been usually done by single judges mm-hmm. and not a bench. And they've almost always happened inside the court, the judge's residence. In fact, not very long ago, just a few months back, mm-hmm. The Nithari accused, the convict Surinder Kohli's death sentence was stayed at 1:30 in the morning by a single judge. But what is unprecedented is for the Supreme Court to get the courts opened at 2:15 in the morning, and a three-judge bench actually drives down and holds court inside the Supreme Court complex. That's not something I remember mm-hmm. In the last two decades or so. That's very unprecedented. Mm-hmm. And then for the hearing to go on for the next couple of hours or so till the early morning, barely hours before the actual execution. That's very unprecedented. To answer your second question, the problem of Indian law and the Constitution is that it's silent on certain aspects. Mm-hmm. It remains silent on how many attempts a person can make in terms of filing mercy petitions followed by other mercy petitions. So technically, applied to file more than one applications, and they have been filed in the past. Mm-hmm. Having said that, we still don't have a written order of this copy, the copy of this written order today, which this court has pronounced. Mm-hmm. But my suspicion is that what the judges have written today will pretty much settle that, because this is a three-judge bench which will rule, mm-hmm. or which has ruled, that you can't keep on filing mercy petitions in the hope that the case gets delayed, and then at a later stage you come mm-hmm. back with a petition which cites inordinate delay,
okay.
and then claim clemency on that
so
ground.
So basically what you're saying is today that precedence will be set for perhaps the future.
That's my suspicion on okay. the basis of presumption that this is what they've written in that okay. actual order.
Okay. Let's go across now to Rahul Kamal, who joins us from outside the Nagpur prison. Rahul, if you can tell our viewers, what time is the hanging supposed to take place?
Sanket, unconfirmed reports just yet, but what we're being told is that there's a high level of possibility, and I want to be very careful over here because we are awaiting a final word yet, but two independent sources we've spoken to have said that the hanging has actually already happened. We're just waiting for a final confirmation. They're saying that the body is currently placed and that the process of hanging started a short while before now. So let's just wait till the time we hear an official confirmation. But authorities in the jail are telling us that the process is currently underway, and it's only a matter of a few moments before they confirm officially that Yaqub Memon has been executed. It's been a night of high drama, the attention now shifting to the Nagpur Central Prison, and I want to show you the level of security. Several cars have been placed through the night. The PCRs of the Nagpur police have been blaring their sirens all across the streets of Nagpur. A very, very high level of security, a very high level of threat as well. But despite everything that was taking place in the Supreme Court, from what we were hearing from our sources from inside the Nagpur Central Prison, all our local correspondents speaking to people inside, they were all saying that their preparations went on. The IG Prisons was here through the night. The medical team came in. Yaqub Memon was given a fresh set of clothing early this morning, and they were completely disregarding what was taking on, what was going on in the Supreme Court, focusing singularly on the task ahead of them. There's a special rope, Sanket, that is used to execute prisoners on a death row. That rope, according to the prison manual, needs to be tested twice over. The last testing was done yesterday in the evening. There's a dummy that's placed. They take Yaqub, they take the convict's measurement in terms of his weight, in terms of his height. Depending on your weight and height, there's a different height that is set. For Yaqub Memon, it would be about 2 meters. That's how much he needs to fall when he's executed. And that is something that is practiced once earlier with a dummy of roughly the same kind of weight to ensure that the rope is strong enough to be able to withstand the execution when it does happen. All of that was worked out to the T. We're also being told that at the Bada Kabristan in Mumbai, some kind of preparations were underway, because the family did indicate that they wanted to take the body to Mumbai. Now, we don't know for a fact yet. We're being very guarded in what we say, because we want to be 100% certain. The family, and nobody from the family directly has spoken to the media, but people who are a part of the same group, people who are accompanying Yaqub Memon's brother Suleiman to Nagpur, they've been speaking off camera to us, and they've said that Yaqub Memon's family wants to take his body back to Mumbai, and they want to bury him at the Bada Kabristan in Mahim. That's something that police authorities here are very wary about. They fear, and rightly so, a possible law and order problem. If the body is taken out, it could turn into a big tamasha. Preparations are also underway for a free funeral to take place inside the Nagpur Central Prison itself. Now, which of the two is ultimately done is not known for sure. We know what the family wants. We also know that the state government is quite wary, wary about it, with good reason. But what they also want to ensure is that this perception doesn't go out that Yaqub Memon, as a convict, wasn't given the due process of law, because the law does allow the family to decide where he will be cremated, unless the state government perceives a law and order problem. So there is that dynamic as well. We've already seen a lot of politics over the execution of Yaqub Memon, with several parties jump up and claim that because he comes from a minority community, he's being targeted, which is not true in the least. But that's their suggestion, and that can really flare sentiments. I must also tell you that now the cops are being very, very careful about allowing people here. But last night, there were thousands. Even now, if you see, there are people who gather just on the sides, right behind where our cameras are. There are people who are gathering. They want to see what's happening. They've got their smartphones up. They're trying to keep an eye on the entire proceeding. And that, again, is very dangerous, because this crowd can get very bloodthirsty, very agitated, very angry very quickly. We were hearing them chant slogans last night, slogans of how Yaqub Memon must hang, slogans of Bharat Mata Ki Jai. Now, that sentiment can get whipped up very quickly, and that again is something that the state government will want to avoid. So there are lots of very sensitive dynamics at play, but we're expecting that in a few moments from now, we will have an official confirmation of Yaqub Memon's that. Just give me a moment. Kaushal Pandey, who's our local correspondent here based in Nagpur, he's been working the telephone lines. Kaushal, what's the update that you have for us?
Right now, sir, abhi aisa pata chala hai ki Yaqub ko phansi de di gayi hai. Wahan par abhi police commissioner gaye hain, lekin Yaqub ko phansi de di gayi hai, aisa jail sutron ka kehna hai.
But I just want to say that while this is a story that I told you when we started, that this is what I was being told as well, but we just want to be guarded and break this officially only when we hear from the police. But tell us, ki subah kya taiyariyan hui, kya kya proceedings hui, jail authorities aapko aur kya bata rahe?
Supreme Court ka decision jaise hi aaya, to waise hi sari cheeze waise pehle se hi taiyari thi. Yaqub ko naye kapde pehnaye gaye, uske baad 5:30 baje usko jo namaz ada karwai gayi, aur namaz ada karne ke baad mein usko phansi yard ke taraf mein le jaya gaya, aur jail sutron ke anusar usko abhi phansi de di gayi.
Okay, your sources also, Amruta, telling you that the execution has possibly happened. We are waiting for a final confirmation. That process started a while ago. Has it been completed?
Yes, even my sources are saying that the execution has happened. And, you know, just before half an hour, we got all the details of the process that he has got the new clothes to wear. He has given the breakfast he wanted and also he has prayed in the morning. So that was the information we were getting from last 1 hour, and now even my sources are saying that the execution is completed.
Okay, and what happens next? The question, Kaushal, is that will the body be handed over to the family? Will they be able to go to the Mahim Kabristan like they want to, or will the body be cremated inside the jail itself?
कल शाम को जो याकूब का भाई है सुलेमान, उसको जेल पुलिस ने एक लेटर दिया था कि आपके भाई को फांसी दी जा रही है और आप अपने भाई की बॉडी ले जाना चाहोगे क्या? तो याकूब ने जो हमारे जो सूत्र बता रहे हैं कि याकूब ने कहा था कि हम बॉडी को ले जाएंगे, लेकिन सुलेमान ने कहा था कि हमें याकूब की बॉडी हम ले जाएंगे, लेकिन जेल वालों की भी शर्त थी कि इसे पब्लिसाइज ना किया जाए, जिससे कि कहीं ना कहीं लॉ एंड ऑर्डर का कोई प्रॉब्लम ना आए.
How do they intend to do it? Because if the body, you're already seeing, it's just early in the morning, more and more people are gathering from the neighboring areas. We saw what happened last night. How will the cops deal with the possible law and order situation if Yaqub Memon's body goes from Nagpur to Mumbai?
Rahul, that is the biggest difficult situation right now here, because at this spot also we can see that there are many people standing here, and if the family decides to take back the body to Mumbai, then that is a big task for Mumbai police also. Though we all know that Mumbai police is already on alert and they have deployed huge police force in Mumbai, but we have to remember that Mumbai is a sensitive city. We have seen many such incidents before, and because of that, especially this topic is very sensitive. The religion matter is also involved in this. So I don't think that administration will take that risk. And from last almost 2 to 3 days, the confusion is still there. What we are getting?
Do we know more details about this letter? What specifically is written in this letter? You are telling us, Kaushal, that the letter says कि क्या आप body को वापस ले जाना चाहते हैं? ये letter में लिखा है.
ये लेटर में नहीं लिखा था, लेकिन ये ऐसा उनको पूछा गया था. लेटर उनको ये दिया गया था कि आपके भाई को कल फांसी दी जाएगी, तो उस समय उनको ये कहा गया था कि उस फांसी के वक्त अंदर तो नहीं, लेकिन आप जेल प्रीमाइसेस में आ सकते हैं.
अभी याकूब मेमन का भाई अंदर ही है?
याकूब मेमन का भाई जेल प्रीमाइसेस में,
जेल प्रीमाइसेस के अंदर है.
हाँ,
ओके. सो टेक अस ऑल्सो अमृता थ्रू हाउ याकूब मेमन स्पेंड दिस मॉर्निंग. इट्स ऑल्सो आयरॉनिकली संकेत हिज 53rd birthday today, and Kaushal in 2010 interviewed Yaqub Memon. That's the most recent interview of Yaqub Memon done by any journalist. So tell us, Kaushal, what was this interview like? How did you set it up, and what did Yaqub Memon say to you during this interview?
Yaqub ka interview bhale hi wo unofficial tha, lekin wo the Hitwad newspaper mein publish bhi hua tha. Yaqub ka interview jab humne kiya tha, to Yaqub बड़ा शांत रहता था उस समय. याकूब से जब पूछा कि आप इतने शांत क्यों, तो याकूब ने मुस्कुराया, और फिर जब उससे और बातचीत हुई कि आपको खुशी नहीं होती क्या, कि आप कब खुश होते हो, कोई त्यौहार आता है या आपके घर वाले मिलने आते हैं, तो सबसे ज़्यादा उसने उस वक्त उसने ये बताया कि मेरी बेटी 10th में 97% ली, सबसे ज़्यादा खुशी मुझे उस समय हुई थी.
एंड अपेरेंटली संकेत ही वॉज वेरी पॉपुलर इन साइड नागपुर सेंट्रल प्रिजन. We've been hearing of how several of the inmates here kept a fast during Ramzan for Yaqub Memon. Uski itni lokpriyata ki wajah kya thi?
Yaqub Memon ko jail mein, chahe jail ka koi bhi qaidi ho ya under trial ho ya koi jail ka official ho, usko sir kehke hi bulate the. Uske piche ka karan ye tha ki Yaqub ek to padha likha tha, kabhi kisi se uljha nahi. Uske alawa Yaqub ne kuch prisoners ko angrezi padhai thi, जिसके वजह से वो जेल में इतना पॉपुलर हो गया था. ड्यूरिंग द रमजान, रमजान में 150 जो जेल इनमेट्स थे वो याकूब के लिए रोजे रखे थे।
ओके तो जब रमजान, ये वाला जो रमजान चल रहा था उन्होंने रोजा रखा था, कि उसने ये भी कहा था कि उसकी आखिरी विश ये थी कि वो अपनी डॉटर से मिले और वो अपनी डॉटर की शादी देखना चाहता था, अपनी बेटी की शादी देखना चाहता था।
याकूब ये चाहता था कि वो अपने बेटी का निकाह कर सके और अपनी बेटी की शादी देख सके, उसमें शरीक हो सके, ये वो चाहता था। जेल में भी उसकी लोकप्रियता अच्छी ही थी, 150 लोगों ने उसके लिए रोजे रखे थे और लोगों को जिसको पढ़ना लिखना भी नहीं आता था उनको भी उसने, कुछ लोगों को उसने अंग्रेजी सिखाई थी।
अमृता, डिस्क्राइब द सिक्योरिटी अरेंजमेंट्स, आई मीन ए यू हैव सीन द विजिबल सिक्योरिटी वेयर देयर इज ह्यूज डिप्लॉयमेंट, दे आर ट्राइंग वेरी हार्ड नाउ टू अवॉइड पीपल कलेक्टिंग गेटिंग टुगेदर, दे आर ट्राइंग टू अवॉइड दैट वेरी वेरी हार्ड, बट वॉट अबाउट outside this place? We are told that there were nakas at different checkpoints getting into Nagpur, several of the sensitive areas, the airport, the RSS headquarters, security has been beefed up there as well?
Definitely. From last 2 to 3 days, security has been beefed up in every area, not only around the prison, not only the area which is around the prison or inside the prison, but there are sensitive areas there also. The Nashik police has kept the huge security force, because as I said, you know, we have also discussed that this is the big day for all of them and big pressure is there definitely on them. So even today also we can see that there is huge police force on the roads of the Nagpur. Everywhere they have the nakabandis, they are checking each and every vehicle, they are checking the number plates of the vehicle, and if the vehicle is from outside the Nagpur, then they are asking for the license, they are asking for the identity, they are asking the people who are on two wheelers. So that is that kind of security they have kept, keeping in mind the sensitivity of this entire matter, of this entire case. And this is not only the case in Nagpur, but definitely they have kept the security such kind of arrangements in Mumbai also.
And in Mumbai as well, security has been beefed up, and we are told that preparations are on, Sanket, at the Kabristan as well, in case Yaqub Memon's body is brought out. We are also being told that the Intelligence Bureau has put out alerts fearing possible reprisals on the back of this execution when it is confirmed officially, because the IB fears that there would be, and of course Yaqub Memon comes from the dreaded Tiger Memon family, given their linkages with the Mumbai underworld, there is a high possibility of some form of retribution, and that again is something that the Indian state needs to be very, very careful about, Sanket.
Absolutely. Rahul, we'll come across to you in just a short moment. Let's also go across to Mumbai, where Sahil Joshi now joins us. Sahil, you're outside the Memon family's residence. Can you just describe to us, you know, the situation over there? Is there greater security that you see outside his house?
Absolutely. In fact, since yesterday, when at 2:30 the Supreme Court doors were open and 3 bench judges started hearing the petition again, since then itself Yaqub Memon's house was started getting flooded with the security arrangements. As you can see right now, the security deployment has been complete here. The QRT team has been placed inside those barricades where Yaqub Memon's family stays in Al Hussaini building, but at the same time, as you can see that police is trying here not to not allow people to come here and gather at this point of time, because what Mumbai police sources are telling us that yes, the government is thinking of handing over the body to the family, Yaqub Memon's body to the family. That body will be brought back to Mumbai. It will be kept at his house for final rites, and after that they are yet to decide whether the final rites will happen at Bada Kabristan in Charni Road, or the final rites will happen in a Kabristan which is close by to this particular building where Memon family stays. It will completely depend on how many people finally gathers for the last yatra, the janaza we call it. At the same time, as you can see, just a while back here, the joint CP of Mumbai Police Law and Order had come, and he took tried to understand the situation here. He also told the media guys not to follow the body today. The Mumbai police will be coming up with a formal letter regarding that. At the same time, they have issued an advisory not to spread any rumors. They are keeping close eye on the social networking sites, especially the social websites like Facebook or Twitter, because in 2 years back Moi police has faced a riot-like situation in Azad Maidan area due to these rumor mongering. So this time.